Ryan Patel joins us from Los Angeles with some analysis. He is a senior fellow with the Drucker School of Management at Claremont Graduate University. Ryan, thanks for joining us. First, a reaction to the fact that there was no agreement and the fact that the talks ended rather quickly without a deal.
Well, the whole no agreement based on the weekend prior before that, you know, it was not going to happen. I was surprised, actually, the Chinese actually delegation kind of came full in force to try to have these conversations. But what doesn't surprise me is where we're at as of today. I know we were all looking pretty good over a month, month and a half, but there were still these big items. Obviously, we've been talking about intellectual property, but what the Chinese have been saying from the very beginning is about not changing some of their laws. And I think once they started getting into the details of that, and they became at an impasse with the U.S. and the Chinese negotiation teams. And you know, at this point now, it's become into the media who said what, who's backing down from what places. And you know, I'm pretty, we're at, actually, this is a pretty big deal. Like, we're at an impasse. There isn't anything about this. We're gonna be really tense next week, especially in Wall Street, to see if there's actually true negotiations or talks going forward, or is it gonna be really quiet?
Well, let's talk about the U.S. tariffs. After that tariff increase went into effect, was there really any hope that a deal could be achieved at that point?
No. I mean, at that point, there's no, I mean, you're sending a message, at least, you know, when you're negotiating in these kind of atmospheres, that we're still not far. If they're really close, you wouldn't do that. You would push the deadline, as they've done in the past, to be able to do a little bit more finiting the negotiation points. But there's still highly critical items in this between both countries that they're not even close. And so this is only putting the pressure back now on China to actually choose to react if they're not going to react and try to open the door, or to have a retaliatory effect, which I have a feeling they will down that path.
Yeah, I was going to ask you what we should expect from Beijing in terms of retaliatory measures. Do you think that will come pretty soon?
Yeah, they've actually been pretty, you know, I think they've learned a lot from last. I mean, everyone's always learning, but from last year when they were going back and forth between the tariffs, you know, they've been pretty calm and you know, thinking about what the next steps are. And I have a feeling that it's going to be. They can't have any reaction. They've been fairly, they haven't been quick with it in this particular round. But you know, to show the public, to show their citizens too, I think you can't just not take a tariff increase. I have a feeling they're going to do something.
Let's talk about the impact of businesses, as you know, that they've been talking about the concerns they have had during this whole trade deal, during the whole trade talks. How much influence do you think those U.S. businesses might have in terms of pushing for an agreement and also a withdrawal of those tariffs?
Yeah, this is, you know, as of Friday, as you mentioned, when this deadline passed and the tariffs went up, I think it caused a lot more pressure and tensions. I think as a whole, or the business community, they were hoping that there would be a deal that would be in set and this whole thing can move forward. But now, since it doesn't look like it's going to get resolved anytime soon, the businesses, you'll see, I'm pretty, you know, the farmers have already, here in the U.S., have already voiced their opinion as of Friday about how there's not a deal. I think you will see a lot more pressure now. I think there was no pressure over the last month and a half, because even Wall Street assumed that there was going to be a deal, and there was a baked in from businesses that, you know, they were going to move forward by the summer. And now at this point, you can see the rhetoric going to, by associations here in the U.S., from retail to a lot of other companies, hardware companies that buy a lot of product from China, they will put the pressure on as of now.
Ryan Patel with Claremont Graduate University, thank you so much.